Hi, and welcome in another episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. Today, I want to show you how to use JSON file in your Logic app. Aussi, si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de ce vidéo. Cliquez seulement dans le coin haut droit de votre écran. Hello again. Let me introduce myself. I'm Frank Boucher, Microsoft Azure MVP based at Montreal. Today I want to show you how you could read, parse, and use a JSON file inside the Logic app. Let's get started. Okay, so we are already in a Logic app inside the Azure portal. The file I want to use today is a JSON file that I use in my reading notes that I publish every Monday. So it's mostly different properties and we want to loop through the cloud, so those nodes, and extract the tags and write a file for every one of them. So our Logic app will be triggered when we drop the file in a folder. So for that, I will use OneDrive, but of course you can use any other file structure. So we need to set our folder. Cloud in 5, perfect. Now that I have my file, what I want to do is parse that JSON file. So we have now a property called JSON. And in data operation, we have the parse that we'll use, parse JSON. We click on that. Okay, to parse the file, we need a schema. So I used to take my JSON and use this website, jsonschema.net, paste it here, and generate a schema. Now it's possible to do it right away in the portal. See this little link here? You click here and you paste your JSON file. It will automatically generate a schema for you. So now what we need to do is parse the file. So I cannot use the file directly. We need to set up correctly. So we'll write an expression. So we'll use here the expression, and if we scroll a little bit, we'll see JSON. So we'll see JSON, and then we want to add the file content. So our expression is JSON trigger buddy. By doing that, we'll transform our file in a JSON object. Perfect. Now, before setting up a loop, we need a counter. So the file will be generating a new file every time. To do that, we can now create a variable here, and we want to initialize it. Initialize variable. Let's call it counter. Well, the type will be integer, and the initial value will be 1. Perfect. Now we are ready to do a loop. So to do that, we'll go and click on the more here, and do add for each. We want to iterate through the cloud since this was my collection. One important step here is to limit the parallelism. By default, Logic App is able to run multiple instances to get better performance. But in our case right now, if we do that, since the counter is local, it won't work. So we need to remove that. So go in settings, turn it off, and we'll set 1 as the degree of parallelism. Okay, now we need to add one action and we'll create a file. So in OneDrive, I want to create a file. So again, we need to specify our folder. Perfect. The file name will be tags underscore and then my counter .txt, and the content will be, that's another thing. Now we need to set up the expression again, and what we want to do is the expression item and set it to use the property tags. Why tags? Because that was exactly the property names that I was using. Perfect. One last, we need to increment our variable. So again, we go and search for a variable. And in here, we should have increment. So increment. Now from the dropdown, pick your variable and add one. Perfect. Now everything is set. We're ready to test. Okay, this is my folder, and I will copy paste my file. Oops, no, before we need to run it. So I click on the run button. So now it's waiting for my file. So we'll put it that way. Perfect, everything run, and if I go in the done, I can go open it in Visual Studio Code, and I will see all my file are generated with different tags. That's it, guys. In few clicks only, I was able to take a JSON file, transform it in a JSON object so I can parse it and then use it. In the next video, I will show how to use this content and pass it to an Azure function. You should subscribe to be sure to not miss it. I hope you liked this video, and I hope it was useful. Be sure to give me a thumbs up if it's the case. See you next time. Bye.